right, welcome back from that short break. Now, of course, a couple of days ago, we have been seeing the What Next signpost moving around, making trends on social media. A couple of people coming through to post about it, and then they delete the tweet. I'm talking about you, Bobby Wine. Yeah, he came about it. Yeah, he did it. I had to.
Okay, what was your take on it?
For him to tweet and delete?
And put down the tweet.
Why would he do that?
What did you?
I mean, he's talking about the government to do all this social whatever he was calling them, and then he's deleting the tweet. I'm like, really?
Is this? What did that
is
show?
Is this the person supposed to be, you know, in the race for presidency?
No. What? What did that show you?
It showed me that he's ignorant about, you know, whatever the government is doing.
Oh no,
as,
you did not.
Trying to better our children is concerned. I'm just speaking out my mind.
I just don't know.
Yeah, we're live on Facebook, so you can send this clip to him. I don't care. But anyway.
You don't like the guy.
Really?
You really don't like the guy.
That's a very strong hate. That's a very strong
no,
hate.
No, I didn't say hate.
I just didn't agree with
you. Because when
I
say I hate someone, I mean it. You get you. I just said you don't like the guy. If I don't like you, it's different from me.
Let me make this clear on air. I like Bobby Wine, but I just don't.
I see you jumping to his music.
Exactly. I just don't like, you know, his ideologies. I don't subject to his ideologies. You get.
Well, I go both ways, you know. I don't like the ideology. I don't even
you don't
understand
like
the
guy. The
person.
So. Oh, yeah. He sometimes he doesn't understand himself.
True, yeah. But even when he was new and his music was just coming up and everyone was vibing to Wendy, I was like, yeah, not my sound.
I thought when you're fighting for people, you have to let your family stay here so that it shows that they're also fighting for you.
Wait, his family is not in the country anymore.
He left.
Oh wow!
That's gonna be true for another day. I do have Timothy, of course, Baliejusa joining me in studio. He doubles as the president of the Uganda Young Plumbers Association. And this morning on the show, we shall be talking about improving, you know, school to work transition through different vocational education levels. Now we began this conversation with, you know, the signpost that went viral. What next? Yes. Now we're talking about transition from school to work. First and foremost, what do you make of the What Next sign? When you saw the pictures going viral on social media, what crossed your mind?
What crossed my mind when I saw the What Next? Well, obviously, you start by thinking, why are these people, do they have to go to the street and, you know, ask the whole world what they should do with their lives? And I did not take it too seriously because I figured maybe they're just uninformed. Yeah. Maybe they just don't have information.
Even after that's going through education?
Yeah.
They are just not ready.
They're just not ready.
They're okay, just not ready for life.
Yeah. Well, because you see...
Oh, shit. I'm still trying to take this in. Like, someone went through, you know, nursery, kindergarten, primary, O-level, L-level, university.
Research, Mulichimu.
They had a gun, they had a function, and...
Then they're like, we don't know what to do now.
Yeah, you're like, what do I do with my life now?
Okay.
So basically, what we are looking at, if we say school to work, is you're leaving school, you're going to get a job. But in looking for work these days, it circles around your network. You know, your network is your net worth. So you're going to start by asking your friends, you're going to ask your family. You know, that is where it circles around. So the what next is basically people are asking each other what next, because right now you're running out of alternatives. Friends and family are not very reliable these days with jobs, because jobs are very hard to get. And that is where the Uganda Young Plumbers Association comes in, under our initiative of Spread the Skill, where we encourage vocational education. Now, in this case, I'm not talking about the plumbing that we, as an association, do. I'm talking about a different kind of vocational education. I'm talking about non-formal vocational education. Now, for this, I'm speaking to companies which actually hire these people.
The plumbers?
No.
Not only the plumbers.
The what next protesters.
The what next, okay.
Yes, the what next. So the companies that hire these people need to look into it and actually see a way forward, because they need workers. I mean, it's not like they don't need workers. The companies need people to work in them. But these people, they claim, are unemployable. So even after you've gone through through school, you've gone through nursery and secondary and university, you're out in the field and you cannot work. You're unemployable.
Yes.
So what we are encouraging these companies to do is establish an internship scheme. You see, if you take on a student who just left the university after university for internship, that gives them an easier opportunity and a greater chance of actually getting employment during or after this internship, because now they actually get training on the job. You see, like, universities give internship in second year. Mm-hmm. You know, you go for your internship, then you go back to school.
Yes. Yeah.
So while you're at internship, you're thinking, you know, I'm doing this, I need the marks, but I have to go back to school. Mm. So this is not really a job. Mm. But if you get an internship after university, you're doing it, yes, you might get marks, depending on the arrangement, but this time it's actually work because you need a job.
A job.
And this is where you're answering what next from. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Because you've finished university, you're now at an internship. This is what is next.
How do we get these companies to be part of this journey? What are you doing as a president to make sure that you have, you know, these companies come through and, you know, help these people that are done with the university?
Now, as an association, we are reaching out to these companies. Mm. But it's not a brand new idea. It's not a grand idea. We have not discovered oxygen. Mm. It's actually happening, you know. Mm. Give you an example. Davis and Shatliff, they actually do this. They actually have this program where they take on interns.
And then PricewaterhouseCoopers, you do it too.
Yeah. You see?
Most companies, the big companies, used to do it.
Yeah. So
and in this transition of talking to the companies, have you registered any success? Do you have a couple of people that, you know, you have taken to these companies and they have done, you know, their work as interns and maybe somehow somewhere they've gotten jobs?
We are actually on the beginning of this great journey because we are reaching out to companies and so far, we have reached out to Uganda Manufacturers Association, which is a set of manufacturers. Mm-hmm. We are reaching out to PSFU, that's Private Sector Foundation, and that's a set, an umbrella organization of companies. Mm-hmm. And we are reaching out to them and we are pitching this idea so that, you know, we can take it to a different level. We are trying to do more than, you know, tweet about it.
Okay. Oh, thank you. I like that. Mm-hmm. I like the fact that he's doing a lot more than just tweet about it. But I mean, it begs the question, though, how sustainable is it? Because if I am a company and say I have a job that I want him to do, but because of the sensitivity of that particular job, I'm going to need someone with some work experience. Because that is usually where the biggest problems for our unemployed starts from. You leave school, you have no work experience, but you need a job. I think my question would be to you, don't you think that's an easier bridge, other than going out to these companies and telling them, okay, if they want to do internships and all of these things, we can merge and all of that, just ask yourself, what happens for a student immediately after they leave campus, before they have any work experience? Does it mean they will never work?
Now, when it comes to work experience, because we've always seen that that has been a natural barrier to employment for fresh graduates, because companies want work experience.
And true.
You just left campus, you don't have any. Mm. So that is where the internship comes in from. Because as an intern, you're not really expected to have much work experience. You're an intern. You're there. You will be working while being trained. So they will train you into their systems. Now, obviously, not everyone is going to be able to be, they won't retain everyone, but they will retain some. And those who they haven't retained now have work experience.
Oh, touche. Makes sense.
Since we're talking about, you know, vocational education, I want to understand how important are these hands-on, you know, skilled labor? How is it coming in for, you know, the people that are actually getting a chance to have this kind of, you know, skill attached to their CV?
Now, when it comes to vocational education, it's the kind of thing that is a guarantee. Vocational education it's an assured deal, because I find it very hard to believe that someone could be skilled with their hands, you know, something you could do with your own hands and make money. It's hard to be unemployed with it. However, the point of vocational education is not necessarily self-employment. Mm-hmm. It is mostly employment in general.
In general. Okay.
Yeah, in general. Mm-hmm. So how the people who have vocational skills on their hands and are able to actually apply them on a job, a benefit is that it becomes easier for an employer to take you on.
True.
Because you have something tangible to show. Mm-hmm. For me, like, say, if I am at MOOBS and I'm studying a bachelor's degree in management, there is no proof of my management skills.
So you're saying
like
that
show us your management.
Some courses are useless. They are irrelevant.
No, no, no. They are not useless.
I am late.
They are not useless in any way. But it's they had to prove.
Yeah.
To our, yeah. You know, it takes time because I have to actually take you on and give you the job so that you can prove that you can do it.
That you can manage.
Yeah. Makes sense. Yeah.
Yeah. But if it's vocational, I can actually prove myself in 5 minutes right there. You know.
Yeah.
Yeah. If it's welding, I can weld something for you, and you can see that I can actually do this.
You
so
can
it's,
do this.
Yeah. It's
quite interesting. As we do get to wrap up, what is your last advice for the youth out there that are, you know, a part of the what next, that are outside, they're home, they're stranded, they don't know what to do after their graduation?
Now, the youth who are stranded at home, as I speak right now, I would encourage them to reach out to organizations.
Mm.
Because as an individual, you cannot do much. That's why we as plumbers formed an association. That's why, you know, that's why Sudhir Ruparelia opened up a company. As an individual, you cannot do much. But if you create a thing or if you join something bigger, you gain value. So they can reach out to organizations. They can reach out to us. The Young Plumbers Association are still, we are very willing and very able to actually help these people and connect them to these internships that we are working on, because the process is underway and we are almost ready to take on people. And
how do they get in touch with you? Social media?
Well, social media, they can follow us on Facebook, Young Plumbers UG.
Young Plumbers UG.
That's a dope handle, man. Young Plumbers. We'll be plumbing.
Yeah, we make it look cool. Yeah, yeah. So
he's
let
informed.
I will plumb
it. Not like the other people.
I'll be your plug.
All right, so head over to social media, get in touch with these guys, and they'll definitely maybe be the bridge that could connect you to the job that you have always dreamt of. We're going for another quick break, but when we do get back this time around, we have gentlemen coming in from the Electoral Commission of Makerere University, and we shall be talking about the elections and why always these strikes when the elections are just around the corner.